Everyone, I hope you all are doing well. Today, what I have here is the German military or army folding mat. This is a product that I reviewed roughly 5-6 years ago, and this is my updated review. This is an excellent piece of kit that is not only lightweight, but very, very versatile. Over the course of the winter, many have seen me use this product with my overnight trips, camping trips, and whatnot. And it's a product that I've used in a variety of ways, not only as a mat, a sleeping pad, but you can use this to sit on, you can use this to kneel on, and so on. In this episode, I'm going over my updated review, my thoughts of this product, and we're going to discuss what has changed since my initial review went live. The primary way that you all have seen me use this mat is as a secondary ground mat. Basically what I do is I take this, I put it down, then I put my sleeping pad on top of it, and this gives me extra protection from the cold, from the snow, from the ice, and so on. For that purpose, it works extremely well, but I am getting ahead of myself. The weight of this is 14 ounces, and as you can see here, it's all folded up. You're looking at almost 15 inches long, 11.5 inches wide, and it has a thickness of roughly 2 inches. You can fold this in half if you want to. I tend not to. This shape right here fits perfectly into most backpacks, and it creates a sort of frame sheet. That is one way that this mat was designed. It goes perfectly with German Flecktarn backpacks and so on. You put this in the pack, you build your gear around it, and this makes a frame sheet. And the dimensions of this when it's unfolded is 74.25 inches long, 21.5 inches wide, and it's roughly 1/4 inch thick. When it comes to the materials of this mat, what you have is a foam inner that is basically covered in a rubberized sort of plastic. I'm not entirely sure what it is, but that's what it feels like. I've not been able to find any sort of information as to accurately what the materials are. So foam inner covered in some sort of rubberized plastic material. All in all, it is extremely durable. And as you can see here, this pad has been used, it's taken some abuse, and it just keeps on going. Even after all of these years, after all of my trips, it's still in great working order. As I lay back on this pad, there's two things that you will notice. One, this is long enough for most individuals. Two, it's not very wide. My elbows, my shoulders, they do stick off the sides of this pad. Now, something that you do not notice is the level of comfort that this provides. This offers just a little bit of cushion from the ground. If you're laying this down on top of grass, you'll be comfortable. If you're laying this down on a hard surface like this, where there's rocks, sticks, and so on, you will feel those rocks. For an example, there's a good-sized rock right here, or actually, it's a stick. It offers just a little bit of protection from that, but not much. Talking about the comfort that this offers brings up the most important aspect that you need to know about this pad. This is a very minimalist pad. It was designed for the army, not for civilians. It was designed for its utility, not comfort necessarily. That's the case with most pieces of military surplus, and it's true with this mat. So if you go out to purchase one of these and you think that you're gonna lay on this and be super comfortable, you're way off. You're way off. It really will depend on how you use this product, whether or not it is comfortable. Again, if you put this down on some rocks, some limbs, some sticks, you will be uncomfortable. You will feel those items underneath you, even though just a little bit less so thanks to the cushion that it offers. But if you can put this on top of a pile of leaves or on top of grass, something like that, it can be quite comfortable. Again, it's all about the use. The right time, the right place, the right purpose. As I mentioned before, the primary way that I use this mat is as a secondary sleeping pad. Usually I put down a ground sheet, put this down, and then my sleeping pad on top of it. This does an excellent job of blocking the cold from the ground coming up through your pad. On those really, really cold nights, it does a great job for that purpose. The next major way that I use this mat is as a kneeling mat. For this purpose, it works very well. It makes an excellent mat to kneel on and also to sit on. Something else that you can do is double it up. You could fold it in half, and in this mode, it is quite a bit more comfortable, not only for kneeling, for sitting, but also for a sleeping mat. A sleeping pad. For those warmer months where you can get away with minimal gear, you can use something like this and you could be fairly comfortable if you double it up. Of course, you don't have any pad for your legs, just for your upper body. I do this all the time in the summer months with my sleeping pads and oftentimes go with half mats, which basically look like this, just a little bit more comfortable. Again, this is a military product, not a civilian camping product, but it certainly can be used for those purposes. As you've seen so far, this is a very versatile mat, and that's what I like about this. You could use this in a variety of ways and it really works well. I mean, you could use this as a sleeping mat, kneeling mat, you can use it as a work mat, you can use it as a shooting mat, you can use it as a frame inside of your backpack, and so on. Because of this coating here, it's very easy to wash off. You can clean this very easily. It doesn't matter if it gets wet or muddy, it just wipes off. It's very easy to fold up. It's easy to deploy. You can even use this inside of your hammock with no issues. It's very lightweight and it really works well as a minimal mat. Another point that I should mention before wrapping this up is that this mat is waterproof. So you can put this down on the wet ground, on the snow and ice, and you don't have to worry about moisture coming through. Now, again, it is narrow, so keep that in mind as that will be important. All in all, everyone, I do recommend this. This is a cool product. There's no doubt about it. It's lightweight, it's versatile. I really like it. I really do. I've had this for a long time and I'm going to continue using it for a long time. You all, since seeing this over the course of the winter, many have been asking questions. Luke, what is that? I have over 1,400 videos here on YouTube, so it can be difficult to find certain things. I get it. That's why I'm here today with my updated review. Since this is an updated review, let's go ahead and talk about price and availability. Things have changed a little bit on that front. In the United States, these are hard to find. They really are. You can find them on eBay, but they will be coming from outside of the US, namely from the UK and so on. That's where you really have to be careful. First off, the price of these has gone up. About 5-6 years ago, these were 20 bucks. Right now they're running from $35 to $45, something like that, plus shipping. So be careful, watch those shipping fees. You will find some sellers wanting to charge as much as $30 to ship this to the US. That's a scam. You should be able to pay roughly around $15 to get these shipped, plus the price of the item. That's reasonable. Anything more than that is ridiculous. To summarize everything, folks, I do recommend this product. It is excellent. It's very versatile. For cold weather, it works great as a place to sit, as a secondary pad, mat. For the summertime, it's a minimalist solution that works well, especially if you're younger. Us older guys laying on this, yeah, it's gonna hurt some. You're gonna feel it. So, yeah. I'm curious to hear from you all. What do you all think about the German folding mat? Do you all like it as much as I do? Comment down below. Also, make sure to share how you've used this product yourself, if you have used it. As an FYI, this is the year of military surplus on the channel, so get ready. Lots of military products are coming up. Many have been asking for a return of the military surplus. It is coming back. There are many pieces of military gear that need updated reviews, so stay tuned. Everyone, take care, strength and honor, hit the thumbs up, it does help the channel, and support the channel if you'd like. The Outdoor Gear Review is agenda free. Everyone be safe, be kind, I'll see you soon.